Alabama Football Review is brought to you by Coca-Cola and your local Coca-Cola bottler. Remember, Coke is it. And by Frito-Lay, maker of Doritos. And by Pony Shoes, manufacturer of fine athletic footwear. Hello and welcome to the Alabama Football Review, week number 3, and another victory for the Crimson Tide. Chris Perkins, congratulations. A great come-from-behind win over Vanderbilt, 44-24.
Well, thank you, Mike. It's a great experience, and I think it's a great learning experience for our football team to have to come from behind like we did, and I think it might be the best thing that could happen to us at this time.
Let's right now get right into those first half highlights, and they are exciting. 41,000 people on hand, full house in Nashville, Tennessee. Coach, on the road for the first time, do you think that had an effect on the players to start the game?
Well, it could have been a combination of things. On the road, a night game, our first night game. I'm not sure that our players really felt like that Vanderbilt had as good football teams they had and that they were going to hit us the way they did the first ball game.
I thought their defense came out and played well early in the football game.
Their defense came out ready to play there early in the game and really, really took it to our offense there early. We gave them the ball in good field position from an offensive standpoint. Two quick times and with a little less than 5 minutes to go in the a little less than 5 minutes played in the first quarter. We're down 14-0.
That was Kurt Pace to Chuck Scott, their tight end, who had 6 receptions on the day. Here's the extra point. It's 7-0. The kickoff, and Alabama has the ball back, and on the very first play, a turnover occurs.
Well, this is a toss to Ricky Moore, our fullback, and he takes his eye off the ball, I think, and he missed the block right there on the line of scrimmage, and it just goes back to their defense again.
They take it down, and their freshman running back, Gary Woods, will take it over from the one-yard line right here. And like you said, Coach, it's 14-0.
It's 14-0 quick, and, in the first quarter, they're going to kick the field goal here in a few minutes, and it's going to be 17-0. But still, that's no time to panic. We just stay with our game plan and keep going, and that's exactly what our players did. We stuck together as a football team and got the job done.
Here, Alabama's drive, they got a couple of first downs, but Walter Lewis misses Joey Jones on a third down play, and once again, Malcolm Simmons has to punt, but this is a great punt. It goes down and is downed at the 2-yard line.
They actually, the first punt, I think Malcolm did a super job punting for us. That's 2 weeks in a row, and that means a great deal to you. When you down the ball on the 1 or 2 yard line and put the offense back against the wall that way, it makes it really tough.
But they get out of it as Page will hit Clay Parker for a 47-yard gain.
They made some big plays in the game. You know, the first play from scrimmage to the touchdown, this play here. They make 5 or 6 big plays during the course of the ball game. We knew that their offense was capable of moving the football. We just felt like the big job for us defensively was to keep them out of the end zone and not let them score as many points.
17-0. What are you telling the players at this point? What's going through the mind of yourself and the team on the sideline?
Well, the main thing here is just not, it's still in the first quarter. And the main thing is just not panic, not get into a panic situation. You're still going to try to get a run-pass ratio of 2-1, which we did all day, and just keep working and make things happen for ourselves.
Here is the third down play again. Alabama is driving, but Walter Lewis and Joey Jones again failed to connect, and the first quarter will end with the score 17-0. But the second quarter, a totally different story. It's a new Alabama team.
Well, we come to laugh. Like I say, we kept working there, Mike, and here's a great run by Larry Patrick, one of several during the course of the ball game. He makes one run going in almost score zone. That's one of the greatest runs that I've ever seen.
Steve Bearden tips the pass and comes up with the interception. Once again, they have good field position.
Kept ball. We had a chance there to make an interception. We had about 3 or 4 more chances to make interceptions from a defense standpoint. Just didn't catch the ball. But our defense played overall, I thought, real, real well. Our entire football team hung together and played exceptionally hard for 60 minutes. And we knew we were going to have to do that.
Walter Lewis gets Alabama out from deep in their own territory. Nice pass
get
here.
Get out of the hole, and we fumble the ball. We get a little bit lucky here. Kick it around up to the 40-yard line. Joey Jones finally jumps on the ball and goes out of bounds.
Once again, though, Alabama does not sustain the drive, as Walter's pass here will be incomplete and have to punt again. But a big turnover, and one of those big breaks you look for is about to occur as Vanderbilt will fumble, and Alabama will get the football back.
Well, normally speaking, if you really play hard and you're hustling on every play for the full duration of the 60-minute ball games, most breaks even themselves out, and that was one for our team.
Alabama's getting ready to take it down for their first touchdown. Ricky Moore here with a gain of 10, and he'll be followed by an amazing run by Lenny Patrick.
That's a good job there. We had three backs. Lenny was over 100 yards, and Ricky Moore was about 98 yards, and Walter had like 92 or 93 yards.
This run, I thought, was just an incredible individual effort on the part of number 25, Lenny Patrick.
Here's a run where they've got him for a three-yard loss. A three-yard loss, and he just keeps those feet moving, keeps that body leaning up forward. Look at this. I mean, he's breaking six, seven tackles right there.
All the way down to the one-yard line, it'll be Walter Lewis. The quarterback sneak. Alabama's on the scoreboard. 17-7. You got to feel good just to get the points on the board.
You know, it was just, when you're down 17-7, you're wanting to get anything on the board just to get you going. You know, whether it's touchdown or field goal, you'd like to think you could make it a touchdown, and we did.
And now it's the defense's turn to shine. They look like they knew what they had to do. Broken play here. Smiley in on the stop, and Stan Gay is going to come up with a good play to
really keep the pressure on their quarterback the way that you'd like to, but that's not criticizing our defensive people that much, because he is a good rhythm passer. When I talk about a rhythm passer, he gets back, and when he gets his drop, he's turning the football loose. He's not holding it very long. And a quarterback that does that, it's hard to get the pressure on and get to him.
Pass to Lenny Patrick for 14 yards. That's why I've Lenny on a running play. This drive led to Alabama's field goal.
Lenny's good running here, picking his way through right up the middle on a running play there.
Lenny, as you said, over 100 yards, 116 on the day. Walter Lewis.
This is the one we get down and get bogged up and miss on a third down situation going for a first down. This is a good run, one of many by Walter Lewis. He just had an outstanding game from a quarterback standpoint.
Walter Lewis scrambling again. This time completes it to Lenny Patrick. And that would set up the field goal by Van Tiffin, who had a good day yesterday. He was 3-for-3.
Well, like I said last week, Mike, he's not going to miss many, regardless of the range that we have him in, because he's a very accurate kicker.
Once again, that defense is going to shine today. Put some pressure on Kurt Page here. Emmanuel King will come in and do some damage to Kurt Page.
It's a great effort right there by all of our defensive front people.
Alabama gets the ball back. And then drive it down again. Joey Jones, who is playing with slightly injured.
By Joey, with the open. Walter did a great job getting the ball to him.
And here's Walter, no receivers open. Apparently, he's going to scramble. And boy, when he runs, he's something to watch.
He makes things happen, man.
11-yard touchdown run. And it's going to be all tied up at 17 as we head into the locker room. Still to come, we'll talk to Rocky Colburn and Lenny Patrick about yesterday's game. Sidney Cohara will have a look ahead to homecoming. And Coach Perkins will be here to talk about the highlights of the second half of the big win over Vanderbilt. Stay tuned. Team effort, but two guys who had outstanding performances yesterday are with me here now. Lenny Patrick, senior running back from Jasper. And Rocky Colburn, junior defensive back from Quintet, Florida. Similar, first of all, congratulations on the game. Lenny, 116 yards. A tremendous effort for you against Vanderbilt.
Well, I appreciate it.
Your thoughts on the game? What your best performance statistically in a long time?
Well, yes. You know, I hadn't carried the ball 25 times since I've been here, so that was kind of a big boost for me. You know, to get the ball that many times and to have a good game like I did. But you know, I can't take too much of that credit. I have to give most of it to my offensive line and. I thank them, you know, if they're out there watching this show, I thank them for blocking like they did.
The whole team did a great job on
right,
that.
Right, very much.
Rocky, it started off, and my heart went right into my throat, 17-0 at the end of the first quarter. What was going through your mind as a defensive back when Kurt Page comes out there and starts firing away and hitting a couple of bombs?
Well, we weren't really concerned about being behind 17-0 at the time. We were just concerned with holding them 17 points right there and letting the offense catch up with them.
Did you make any adjustments at all as far as what you were doing as a defensive back in the game?
No, we just tightened down a little bit and tried to fight back against the adversity that was on us. We didn't want them to score any more points, so we maybe tightened up our coverage just a little bit.
Rocky, do you and the defensive players have confidence that the offense could come back and was going to put the points on the board?
Oh, sure, we were. We were very confident that we were going to come back and win. There was no doubt in our minds that we were going to win the game.
Lenny, I'll ask you, when you were down 17 to nothing, the team is down, does that put more pressure on the offense? What were you thinking at that point?
Well, like Rocky just said, you know, all along everybody, I think, was thinking we could still come back, you know, after we was down 17 points. It was more like, you know, just a letdown for the first 5 minutes of the game, because when anything go our way, and so, you know, it was kind of like the offense just had to come and do something big, you know, to get the pep on the team, because we had got down, and they fans was just crazy as everything, and, it was all right.
Do you think it's good for the team, the fact that you did get come down 17 to nothing, and you showed you can come back?
Right. It will help the team in the future. That's all that I could see, you know, we got out of it.
Rocky, so much has been said about this young defense. If there's a weakness at Alabama, it may be in the secondary. Do you feel maybe that you came back and proved something against a great quarterback in Kirk Payne?
I think we did. We really come around this year. We showed the people that, you know, we're not just a young, weak, non-conference kind of defensive team. We showed them that we can come back and play like the Alabama teams of old on defense.
Lenny Patrick, congratulations on a great performance again.
Okay.
Rocky Colburn, way to hang in there, way to fight. I'm proud of it. And gentlemen, thank you again for being our guest today.
All right.
It's homecoming week at Alabama. Sidney O'Hara now is going to have a special look at what homecoming is all about, some homecomings of the past. I'm looking forward to that big Bama blast coming up Friday night. And, of course, the big game is on Saturday against Memphis State. And now here to tell us more about homecoming is Sidney O'Hara.
The university held its first homecoming in the early 1920s. Then, as now, there was more to it than just a football game. For several years, it was held on Armistice Day, and the entire city remembered the war to end all wars by trying to save the parade to end all parades. There were speeches, a road race, and a football game. If anyone's an authority on Alabama homecomings, it must be this man, Jeff Coleman. After all, he's been a part of every one of them since 1924.
But I think even back to the days when they had special trains to come in from Birmingham and before the days of automobiles, the alumni enjoy coming to homecoming just as much, did enjoy just as much then as they do now. It's just a different atmosphere, social change in different ways. But it's still a big day in university life, the University of Alabama.
Once I built a tower, now it's done.
Going to have to tie at 17. Did you make any changes in the locker room at halftime? Are you going to do anything different?
Well, Mike, anytime you're down 17-0 in the middle of the first quarter and go in the locker room, you have to feel kind of lucky to be tied at 17-all, so you make a few changes, but not that many, especially when the score was the way it was and occurred in the manner that it did occur. We put them in good field position there from an offensive standpoint on a fumble and on a short punt, and so we put our defense in a bind there to give them an opportunity to get those first two touchdowns. So we have to take that in consideration. The big thing that we have to do now is go out the second half and play our type of football.
The team looked awfully confident running out on the field to start the second half. Did you feel that on the sideline?
Well, I felt confident in the dressing room that we would go out and take it to them a lot better than we did in the first half, the second half, yes.
Let's take a look now at those highlights of the second half. Start the second half. There have been some problems with injuries at linebacker. But Vincent Elder, who played a lot last night, is going to come up with a big play here on the first series.
Tell you what, Vincent Elder comes up with a great play here, but you know, our two inside backers, they played an awful lot. Vincent Elder and Todd Roper, they played exceptionally well.
Well, turnover, and Alabama has the ball in great field position, and watch Walter Lewis do his thing again.
This is a big play coming out to start of the second half. The defense turns the ball over to you. Now what do you do with it from an offensive standpoint? Take advantage of it and put some points on the board. Here's Lenny Patrick again with another great run. Lenny had a great day. So he makes a great cut right here to make a attacker miss him in the open field, and a great back does that.
Gain of 16 yards. He had 116 on the night. Lenny Patrick. And here's the touchdown, number 25, going over the top.
He just goes in, great sure effort back there. That's great effort on his part.
I would imagine that this has to give the defense a lot of confidence as well.
Well, coming out the second half, and, you know, they turned the ball over to the offense. The offense takes advantage of it, puts the touchdown on the board. Sure, it works hand in hand. Each of the segments of the football team, kicking game, whether it's the offense or whether it's the defense, here standing game making a great play here on the sideline. But each of the phases might give the others and flows over as far as the confidence factor is concerned. Here's another great play by Joey Jones. On reception from Walter Lewis on the second down play.
This will set up a 28-yard field goal by Van Tiffin. Upton, good. Alabama 27, Vanderbilt 17. But Vanderbilt's a team that wouldn't quit, though, because they
came back. No way. We knew that. I think the players knew that. You know, but they come out, here's another one of those big plays that they came up with. Hitting one of the receivers in a big seam area. And lose the ball down real quick. That's what hurts you. That's what hurts. You know that the team, and we knew that they were going to lose the football game. It's a passing game that they have. The big thing that you want to try to prevent is those big plays that lead them down the field real quick. Keep the toss play, we just miss some tackles there, and they take it in for the touchdown.
Gary Woods on the touchdown, and Vanderbilt, as we said, not quitting at all, 27-24. But Alabama's offense, they take the ball and march it down the field once again. Joey Jones,
I think this is a great return that we have here. It gets us in great field position here at Joe Carter after the 39-yard line. That's a great place to start with the offensive football team.
Joey Jones, I thought, had a very, very good game last night. And here comes a big reception by number four.
Mm-hmm, that was a great catch. He made several. Joe Smith made several great catches. There's one of them here.
And it will be Joe Carter on the touchdown run of 6 yards.
This is Ricky Moore, our fullback. He punishes people when he runs the football.
And here comes Joe from the 6 yard line.
Quick handoff, we just pop it right up the middle, and there's Joe scoring the touchdown.
34-24, but still, the game is not in hand at the moment.
Nope. Not against this football team. Not the way that they can move the football. Remember last week how they won that one? With just 1:05 or 1:10 on the clock, they marched down the field and scored a touchdown. Without utilizing any timeouts because he didn't have any.
Here, Page scrambles and finds Ardell Fuller for a first down.
This is a play that they were very effective with. This is where they drop the quarterback back, make it look like it's a straight drop back pass, and then roll him out to one side or the other and put him to either a three receiver side setup, and it was very effective.
We're in the fourth quarter now. Greg Richardson, a nice punt return of 16 yards. And Walter Lewis to Joe Smith, one of those receivers that you mentioned a moment ago.
Play action pass there, hit and go over the middle again. Joe did a great job for us last night. Here's a quick hit and play, the same play that Joe Carter scored a touchdown on. We pop it up through the middle there for about 14 yards.
Walter Lewis is going to do some running of his own on this play. It'll be a gain of 13 yards.
Takes it down. Say, he has a unique ability as far as a sense of where people are on the football field. Sometimes you feel like you've got eyes in the back of his head. Getting quiet, get it up there. This is the blitz. This is down inside. On the call, we've got a blitz lead built into it, but we didn't quite get it up there far enough for him. It's a great play by our defense, making the tackle on the quarterback there on the 1 yard line.
Van Tiffin from 39 yards out, his longest field goal of the night, and his third of the night. 37-24 is the score.
And you're still not feeling comfortable at this point, Mike. Not with this team. Here's again a little play action pass that makes a great reception over on the sideline. Say, Page does a great job with this offense. He's got a little. Quick drop back, spin out again. Quick hitter up in the middle again, the same one that Joe scored on, and popped one wide open. Great run there by Lenny Packett.
Alabama could not move the ball any further. Here comes a great interception on this play.
Great interception. They've been picking on Freddie Robinson there, especially in the first half. Completed a couple of passes in front of him and so forth, but he comes up with a great interception there at the end of the game.
You talk about effort, watch Ricky Moore on this run.
This is the option. We haven't been running the option or utilizing it the way that we probably should, and run it as much as we probably should, but all this is put back gear option and we pop it in there, and Richard does a great job running it into the touchdown.
Final score of the night, they made it 44-24 with the extra point.
Pretty a nice way to finish up the day, Mike.
And they're still trying to go down for one more score. However, the defense won't let them.
They're never going to give up. I can guarantee you that. They're a good football team, and they're going to win more games than a lot of people are going to give them credit for.
The final score, Alabama's third victory of the season. We hear so much talk about the words character and pride. I think the Alabama football team really displayed those attributes yesterday.
Well, I think our team came together yesterday and played very well as a football team. Hung together when they needed to, when it was the only way to get it game pulled out, really. You know, down 17-0, they could have easily panicked. They did not. None of us did, I don't think. And, I think that does show a lot of character in class.
Think this will pay off down the road?
I'm certain that it will, Mike. I think it's probably one of the best things that could happen to us at this time. I've always thought that early in the season, some of the best things that can happen to a football team is say have the opportunity to see if they can pull a game out in the last 2 minutes of the game. You know, a head coach on the sideline would rather not have to do that early in the season, but if you can do it from a team standpoint, I think it helps from a confidence factor standpoint. Certainly coming back from a 17-point deficit and playing the way that we did in the second half has to help us slip down the road confidence-wise.
Coach, congratulations on the team's third win of the season, and hopefully we'll be here talking about a victory next week.
Thank you, Mike.
Next week it is homecoming against Memphis State, and we'll be back here on Sunday with the highlights. So long, everybody. It's the most